Happy Shanty Day number 103.
103.
Man.
Yeah.
Yeah. Saturday. Made it Saturday. Hooray. And, yeah. I'm Sky.
I'm Sagan.
And we're siblings. And we sing sea shanties. I have too many thoughts in my brain at one time. yeah, we had kind of a sad one for you yesterday. Sorry. Yep. We gave you a tissue warning so that you knew that was coming. Tissue warning. But yeah, like we said yesterday, it's good to get all of the gamuts of music. That's an important thing. But today we have one that's also about
a nautical disaster.
But it has a happy ending this time. It does. It's a crazy story.
It is. It's a crazy story. And this is just like 3 Score and 10, this is also a true story. So on the 19th of January in 1881.
Your birthday.
That is my birthday.
In 1881?
Nope.
Oh.
Spoiler alert, January 19th is my birthday.
Yep.
Maybe
we'll still be doing this on your birthday.
I hope not. after several days of heavy snowfall, at about 10:30 in the morning, the harbor master at Whitby received a telegram that a ship, the Whitby Visitor, had sunk off of Robin Hood's Bay, and that her crew had taken to the ship's boat, but had been forced to drop anchor and were unable to reach land because of the very heavy seas. So the severity of the wind and the seas at Whitby made it impossible for the Whitby lifeboat to be launched and sailed around to Robin Hood's Bay. So the lifeboatmen decided to take the lifeboat 6 miles overland to Robin Hood's Bay and launch from there. This was across narrow roads and some moorland, some 500 feet above sea level and drifting snow up to 7 feet deep in places. About 60 Whitby men were given shovels and began digging to clear the snow from the roads. Horses were hitched to the lifeboat carriage, and the Robert Whitworth, which was the name of the lifeboat, set out on her journey. Eventually, some 200 men joined in the snow clearance work. Additional horses were obtained from farmers on the way, eventually numbering 18. Men from Robin Hood's Bay started from their end,
right, clearing the other end clearing pathway, the snow. Yeah.
And after 2 hours, the lifeboat descended the very steep hill into the village. The crew of the lifeboat had been involved in the digging, but tired though they were, they then manned the boat and set out to rescue the stranded sailors. Before they could reach them, 6 of the boat's oars and the steering oar were smashed by a heavy wave, and they had to return to shore. While the oars were being replaced, Cox Henry Freeman asked for volunteers to double bank the oars, and the lifeboat set out with 18 men on board. And after an hour and a half of fighting against the seas, managed to reach the sailors in the small boat, and then returning them to Robin Hood's Bay at 4 p.m. The 6 rescued crew members all needed medical attention, as did some of the lifeboat crew, but everybody made it out alive.
It is crazy. It is, like, yeah. You read some of these stories about these early lifeboat crews. Uh-huh. Like, I mean, hats off to the Coast Guard. Like, they're still out there doing this kind of stuff. Yes. But luckily for them, they have a lot more technology, yep, and a lot stronger boats and, uh-huh, things than they did back in the day.
Yeah.
Still super, super tough gig.
No, but
man,
they were just like,
early lifeboats.
We'll take it 6 miles.
Yeah, there's a boat stuck out in the ocean, so we're gonna bring another boat
across the land over to it, and so, because we can't sail around, so we'll just make it work.
Yeah,
we're just gonna make it work.
Amazing. And all of these people from the local villages that were like, yeah, here, use my horse, yeah, or here, I'm going to come out and help you shovel. And
yeah, I feel like this should be like a movie.
It should. I would agree. I feel like it should be a movie as well. I know there are some movies out there about, yep, some of these early lifeboat crews.
Yeah.
Because this is just one of, you know, mm-hmm, thousands of stories about these.
Yeah.
Just incredible. I mean, this was dangerous.
Like, telegrams. And they didn't have cell phones. Yeah. They didn't have radios. They didn't have anything like this. They had, right, to, like, click it out.
Yeah, to call for... It is amazing the human ingenuity of just trying to figure
determination
out... Yeah, of how are we going to bring these guys in? And, you know, you had hundreds of people that were just trying to get these 6 guys,
yep,
off of this boat.
The community coming together.
Yeah, it's amazing. So it has a happy ending.
It does have a happy ending.
We figured we owed you a happy ending after yesterday. So, but this is also a really pretty one too.
It is. However, the shanty giveth and the shanty taketh away. So this is something a bit different from any other shanty that we've ever had, and that is the chorus changes. The chorus changes. Right. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So there's five. It has the same chorus for 5 verses, and then the chorus changes for.
For storytelling purposes.
Right. Hang on. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so it has the same chorus for 4 verses, and then for 1, 2, 3, 4. And then for the other 4 verses, the chorus changes. The melody stays the same, but the words change.
Right. So the front half is about the digging through the snow and the horses that were there to help pull the boat and that kind of thing. And then the last 4 are about the actual, okay, we've made it to the harbor now we have to figure out how to get out to
the boat, get it back.
So for storytelling purposes, the chorus lyrics change, the tune is the same.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yep. And
the words are down below.
The words are down below.
Because you may want
them. The song, I don't know, the song is called Robert Whitworth.
Yeah.
Named after the, named after life. But, so the first chorus is, shovel the snow, lad, 7 feet tall, hooves a pounding, clear and haul, clear and haul, lads, clear and haul, hooves a pounding, clear and haul. And then the second chorus, which is for the
same tune, different words.
Yep, the last 4 verses is pull the oars, lad, 7 feet tall, waves a pounding, heave and haul, heave and haul, lads, heave and haul, waves a pounding, heave and haul.
Just listen to him and follow the lyrics that
are below. So the first verse is hooves a pounding,
right,
clear and haul. And the second one is waves a pounding, heave and haul.
Right, which
so
makes,
there's the, those
which
the
makes
fundamental
sense.
Differences.
And in context, I'll probably get more of it right. Probably.
We'll
find out.
Here we go. Well, it's not, you know, it's really good because I have never once messed up the words.
It's true.
To these shanties.
If you go back and watch all 102 that have happened
I have
so far,
never, I've never,
you can see
I've never
he has
flubbed
never,
a line.
Ever done
I've
that.
I've never messed up a line.
I do basically every episode.
Yep, it's true. Yep. Whenever we have had to start over on any of these recordings,
it's definitely
always been because of her and never because of me.
Yep.
I am perfect, and that's just how it is.
Yeah.
It's just how it is, the shanty.
Sounds great. We'll send a lifeboat for you.
I'm lying. That's the joke.
Oh.
Captain Gibson, hear our plea. 6 men's lives in peril at sea. Send the boat, oh, send the boat. The Whitby Visitor is no more. Shovel the snow, lad, 7 feet tall. Hooves a pounding, clear and haul. Clear and haul, lads, clear and haul. Hooves a pounding, clear and haul. Coxswain shouting, can't you see? We could never clear that sea. Boats not for sailing, not today. But 6 men's lives we shall yet save. Shovel the snow, lad, 7 feet tall. Hooves a pounding, clear and haul. Clear and haul, lads, clear and haul. Hooves a pounding, clear and haul. Grab the shovel, seas of snow, through blizzard drift we shall go. O'er the moors, lad, o'er the moors, at Robin Hood's Bay we'll launch there. Shovel the snow, lad, 7 feet tall, hooves a pounding, clear and haul. Clear and haul, lads, clear and haul. Hooves a pounding, clear and haul. Harness fastened, leathers tight. Ne'er anyone had seen such sight. Steady up, boys, steady up. Mighty beast, haul the load. Shovel the snow, lad, 7 feet tall. Hooves a pounding, clear and haul. Clear and haul, lads, clear and haul. Hooves a pounding, clear and haul. Hundreds fight the snow that day. More horses harnessed on the way. Twixt cozy homes with fires aglow. But pounding seas still lay ahead. Pull the oars, lad, 7 feet tall. Waves a pounding, heave and haul. Heave and haul, lads, heave and haul. Waves a pounding, heave and haul. Exhausted men can barely stand, but the Robert Whitworth will be manned. Oars all smashed and steering broke, with salty tears they head for shore. Pull the oars, lad, 7 feet tall. Waves a pounding, heave and haul. Heave and haul, lads, heave and haul. Waves a pounding, heave and haul. We'll try again, we shall not fail. 18 men shall fight the gale. Hours past, men hauled aboard. White horses crashing to the bay. Pull the oars, lads, 7 feet tall. Waves a-pounding, heave and haul. Heave and haul, lads, heave and haul. Waves a-pounding, heave and haul. I'm so glad the sun decided to come out. There's one verse, one verse! Such a journey, never forget. And his strength will save men yet. Fight nature's forces for precious life. Lifeboat men, to you our praise. Pull the oars, lad, 7 feet tall. Waves a-pounding, heave and haul. Heave and haul, lads, heave and haul. Waves a-pounding, heave and haul. There you go!
Oh, man. Sorry, we have shades. We have a big window in this particular room, and we typically tend to pull the shades down when it's a really sunny day. And when we started this video, it didn't really seem like that.
The sun was behind the clouds.
And then as it got further and further, it looked like we were getting closer to the surface of the sun there.
Thanks for that. Thanks for that dramatic lighting change.
Yeah, it was great.
There, sun.
So there you go. There's your happy ending. And go lifeboat, people.
I don't know. That's all I got.
That's about all we got. We'll be back again tomorrow. Be safe. We love you. And see you again tomorrow. Bye! Bye.